Hey, Mitch.
Hey, Greg.
What do you call a nosy pepper?
I don't know.
Jalapeno business!
Hello, and welcome to the first episode of The Lab, a new series here on ASAP Science, where we take your questions and turn them into experiments so we can experience science firsthand. My name is Mitch.
And I'm Greg, and we are ASAP Science. And don't worry, the animated videos are still going to be coming out every week, but on Sundays leading up to the new year is our first series of The Lab, so tune in on Sundays. And Mitch, what exactly are we doing today?
So today we're actually looking at the science of pain, and we're going to start out by having a lot of spicy peppers to understand why spice feels like pain.
And then we're gonna be putting our hands in some really cold water and see if swearing can actually help with pain.
And finally, we're gonna be getting electrocuted to talk about the anticipation of pain and how awful that is.
Do you think you're gonna be good at this?
No, I'm like so weak. Okay, I'm the weak one of this group.
I have red hair, jeans, so you know, I can like handle anything.
Yeah, they're all gonna be challenges, by the way, so should we just start?
Yeah, let's do this.
All right, first up, we have our spicy pepper challenge. We've ordered these peppers from least spicy to most spicy, and then we have a list of facts. So every time we bite a pepper, we have to spew off a spicy pepper fact.
And this is the hottest pepper in the world, the California Reaper, so we're really excited about this one. Hopefully we're not gonna projectile vomit on the camera. And the first person who grabs this milk for relief loses the challenge. So, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Spicy peppers excite receptors that usually respond to heat, and these are known as nociceptors.
These nociceptors respond to temperature extremes. Oh my god, it's actually really hot. A mechanical stimulus, but they can also obviously respond to chemicals. I want to spit it out and drink my milk. It's big.
When you eat a hot pepper like this one, your central nervous system gets very confused. Bring it.
Oh! Capsaicin is the active ingredient in hot peppers, which stimulates the nerve to respond to mild temperature increases. And it sends two signals to the brain, that it's warm and that it's an intense stimulus, which causes this burning sensation.
This is awful.
Should we just have the milk?
I'm so white, like I'm in so much pain.
I don't think I can do this. It's getting worse, like it's
only. My glasses are on.
Okay, I quit. Oh my god, that feels so good. Just drink your milk.
No! So this is a ghost pepper.
Be careful, man.
The signal creates the same physical reaction to heat that includes vasodilation, sweating, and flushing. You feel tingling in my finger. And that's it. You sweat and you flush and you vasodilate my hand. My hand feels
weird. I'm sweating. Okay, I'm gonna read my other fact because I already lost.
My right hand is tingling. I touched my eye!
Oh my god. No. Are you okay? Don't touch it more.
Okay, I'm done.
Go wash your hands.
Wait, I think I need to put milk in my eye.
No, okay, go wash your hands. Okay. It was interesting, one researcher actually gave rats spicy foods to see if they would actually like it. And it turns out humans are one of the only animals in the world that will choose to eat spicy things. I'm literally drooling. Choose to eat spicy things over stuff that actually isn't spicy. So how do you feel? Explain to us how you feel.
Like a fool for saying that. I was like, I'm so good at pain. Okay, Mitch. So what? Why is milk helpful for us?
Well, so water is not helpful because capsaicin is actually hydrophobic, so the water doesn't really do anything except swash it around all around your mouth, whereas the milk actually absorbs it, brings it down to your stomach, and actually is a chemical reaction that makes it feel a whole lot better. So avoid water, stick to milk.
And also, the relief that you feel when drinking this milk excites the pleasure centers of your brain, which is why this feels so good right now.
And why people go back to spice, even though they know it's awful.
Also, I'm gonna give up on coffee. Ghost pepper every morning.
Yeah.
I'll be awake for 24 hours. So pain actually is something that is used to protect your tissue from damage. So for example, if you touch a hot burner, your tissue's getting damaged immediately and you feel the pain immediately. But some things actually take more time to feel the pain.
So to elicit some slow pain, we have these buckets filled with ice. We're each gonna put our hands in them to see how long we can last. But the one caveat being that Greg is allowed to swear and I'm not.
Yeah, you better believe it. Okay, are you ready for more pain?
I think so. Okay, time to roll up and put in.
Okay, we have to do the exact same time to be as scientifically accurate as possible.
All right, ready? 3, 2, 1.
Ah! Ooh, okay, so.
Oh my God, I don't
know. A study actually found that when people were allowed to swear, they were able to keep their hands in ice water for on average 40 seconds longer. It's because it actually releases in your brain the fight or flight response, it releases adrenaline, and you feel a lot better. Holy pigeon.
One interesting thing is how when you swear too much, you can actually overuse that.
No, you can't.
Anyway, I'm actually in so much pain.
Well, I'm feeling great. Fingering a butt.
Oh my God. Oh, it actually like hurts. Are you seriously holding it still?
I am.
That's crazy.
But maybe my hand's just gonna pull out and like my lip's like, gonna come out and my hand's gonna still be in here. I'm like,
One weird thing was that my body actually like heated up. My face and body felt so hot when that was happening. I think it was just like a fear response. I was like, I'm gonna lose my hand. Okay, oh my God, how do you feel?
Ooh, it's like when you come in from the cold.
It is kind of nice when it like, happens. It's like, well, Greg won challenge number two as well. I clearly am a wimp.
So one thing that we've learned from this is that swearing is great. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it is time for a shocking experience. They say that the actual anticipation of pain can actually be worse than the pain itself. How does it work, man?
I don't know. So we've been given this ball, and apparently we stick this key in, and it starts zapping at random intervals.
So also, it says on here, this product emits electric shocks, keep out of reach of children under 14. It may interfere with the electric health devices, such as a pacemaker, and do not use this if you have a heart condition or any other related illnesses. And then it says, in all caps, this is not a toy.
We have to hold the ball while we're reading the fact, and as soon as we're done, we can pass it off, and the other person has to finish the next fact. We're playing to three, right?
Yeah.
So first person who gets three loses.
Three shocks, yeah.
I have really bad anticipatory, like, fear, so, like, I'm
but
actually
But you have to go first, because I want to see you.
No.
Go.
Okay. Is it lighting? Oh my God, it is. Okay.
Okay. Go.
I'm just... Studies have found that both meditation and exercise can reduce or modulate feelings of pain.
No!
Oh!
The placebo effect can act! No, it's going on!
It shocked you, stop. No, stop,
didn't work
stop.
For me.
Oh! I think you won that. Did you also get electrocuted?
Yes! I electrocuted, like, six times!
I'm actually shaking, this one. What the hell?
Okay, the placebo effect can work for pain if it's high end. In a 2008 study, patients received painful electric shocks. Afterwards, 10-cent placebo pill was given to the test subject, which alleviated pain for about 64% of the participants. A $2.50 placebo pill reduced pain for 85% of participants.
Chronic pain can shrink the size of your brain, and a study of individuals who, with chronic pain, could show up to 11% less.
Almost broke my laptop. You threw it at the screen of my laptop.
I did not have a choice. I think I should start this
time.
Yeah,
that's fair.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get shocked again. Platypus are one of the few mammals to produce venom. Though the venom isn't powerful enough to kill a human, the pain is excruciating and could last for a month.
Naked mole rats don't feel the pain of acid or the sting of chili peppers.
No! Oh, you cheated. The scientific term for brain fees is...
Naked roll rats don't feel spice. Fascinating. Short and fascinating.
Okay, let's talk about anticipation. That was, it's not as bad as I thought it was at first, but it is shocking.
No, and the worst part is when you get it handed to you and you're like, it's gonna come. But then as soon as you do get shocked, you're right.
You get scared,
for you,
but then,
you just throw it away.
Well, my hand, you didn't ever get it, so you don't even know.
I did, I got your secondhand electrocution.
Okay, so winner of this entire game has been Greg. So we made it through all the pain and suffering, but it was all for the sake of science.
And now it's time for This Week in Science Talk.
This week, scientists have started to discover how we actually spend our time. Using information from over 1 million participants, scientists found that we don't actually work more than we did in the past. We just tend to multitask a lot more, making our lives seem more hectic.
You might not care much about your poop, but your brain does. Neuroscientists have found that microbes in your gut can affect your brain development and also your mental health. Known as the poop study, scientists are looking at how microbes affect a baby's brain development. So next time you're changing a diaper, take a good look at that turd.
Speaking of poo, did you know that naked mole rats actually eat each other's poo? But for good reason. Research has shown that when underlings eat the hormone-rich poo of a queen, the added estrogen in their system actually prompts them to help take care of her offspring.
Let us know if you know of any other news from this week in science. Use the hashtag twist, and we're going to put all the information to the studies we just talked about below.
Our Twitter and Instagram handles are right here, which you can follow. And thank you so much for watching the whole first episode of The Lab. We had a lot of fun making it. If you have other questions or experiments you want to see us try on this new series, let us know in the comments below.
And make sure you subscribe to ASAP Science. We have a new whiteboard video coming out this week, and we'll see you next Sunday for the next episode of The Lab. See you then.